Hey guys, what's up? And it's time to do a full review of the Samsung Galaxy A30, and I am using this phone for about 2 days. And in this video I am talking about everything about this phone. And first up, I am talking about the build quality of this phone. And this phone is completely made up of the plastic head, and I have to say that the back is made up of the polycarbonate material. And let's quickly show you the physical overview of this phone. And first up, I have to say that the front is made up of a Corning Gorilla Glass 3. And let's quickly show you the physical overview of this phone. And you can see on the back is having a fingerprint scanner and vertical dual cameras and LED flash. And you can see the color is looking very shiny in different lighting condition. And on the bottom is having a headphone jack, microphone and a speaker and USB Type-C port. Yes, it is a USB Type-C port. And on the right is having a volume up and volume down rocker with a power key. And I have to say that the sides of this phone is a little bit curved. You can hold this phone very easily. And on the top is having a noise cancellation mic, and on the left is having a SIM tray. You can use two SIM card and one micro SD card at the same time. And let's talk about the display quality of this phone. And it is a 6.4-inch Full HD Super AMOLED display, and it is a Super AMOLED display. You know, the Super AMOLED display, it is the best display in the world right now. Very good color reproduction indoor as well as outdoor, and it is a Infinity U display. Samsung called as Infinity U display, but it is a water Doppler notch. First time it is showing in Oppo F9. Now Samsung is giving you a Infinity U display. There we have the 16 megapixel front camera with the earpiece off top of this 16 megapixel front camera, and the bezel is very big on the bottom, but on the top is having a very small. That's a very good thing about this phone. And display quality is absolutely incredible, and it is very battery efficient as well. And you can see it is a very good display, and the color reproduction is absolutely mind-blowing of this phone. And let's talk about the software of this phone. And this phone comes with a Samsung One UI which is based on Android 9.0 Pie, and you can see Android version 9. That's a very good thing about this phone. And version 1.1, and you can see, and the last security update is having a 1st February 2019. And I have to say, it is a One UI. You can use this phone only one hand. It is a very easy UI, and you can see all the things option in my one hand. I can reach all the option only using one hand. And you can see same thing with the notification panel. You can double swipe, and all the notification panel is here. And you can see, and night mode is also here. That's a very, very good thing about this phone, and it is giving you a much better battery life compared to the off night mode. Always on display is also here. Let's quickly show you one click, and you can see always on display is here, and it is very good, and it is not a very battery hungry as well. And the fingerprint scanner is on the back, I have to say, and I have to say, and you can actually hide the notch, but I will say Infinity U display, you can actually hide the Infinity U display in the settings as well, going to full screen apps. And you can see Samsung called as hide front camera, and I click that, and you can see, and it is also looking very good. But I am using this because it is a Super AMOLED display with a Infinity U display with a 6.4-inch Super AMOLED display. This one is giving me a awesome experience, and I play as for 9. That's a very huge thing about this phone. Very good color production as well as the bezels. I cannot notice the Infinity U display in S for 9. And auto brightness sensor is also here. All the sensor is here, what you expect on a Samsung phone. Not a Samsung phone, all the phones like Oppo and Vivo, all the sensor is there. Gyroscopic sensor is also here, but NFC is not here in this phone. Blue light filter is also here in this phone, and auto brightness sensor is also here. And here is a always on display setting. Let's go to the always on display, and this phone is giving you a like this lock style, and you can see that all the also customize the color as well. Here is a lock screen, and you can see a lock screen setting. You can actually change the time style as well, and you can actually customize the color of this lock screen area. And it is a new thing with the One UI, and it is a digital well-being. It is showing me a what you use the YouTube and other application, and you can see Facebook I am use this area, and YouTube I am using this area. And today I am using this phone for about 44 minutes and some more, and you can see wind down system is also here in this phone. I have to say every application I am using only one hand. I go back, I am using open, and you can see one UI. It is very easy to use this phone only one hand. I does not use the second hand for bring the notification down, and it is a device care. And this phone comes with a 64 GB internal storage out of 49.9 GB is available out of the box, because I am installed some application like S19 as well as my social networks app. You can see this phone is giving you a two keyboard things. You can enable the night mode, it is going to the dark, and some more high contrast keyboard. And you can see I enable, and here is a some more keyboard things. And you can see I am going to the advanced feature, and dual messenger feature is also here. Let's go to the motion and gesture system, and double tap to wake up, the display is here, but the lift to wake up is not here in this phone. And some more feature in the motion and gesture area folder, and here is a reduce animation feature. You can reduce the animation and it is looking little bit faster than before. And let's quickly show you the fingerprint scanner speed as well as a face ID. And you can see, let's show you the feed, and it is half a second and it is unlocked. Let's quickly show you the face ID like this, and it is some animation on the top, and you can see it is looking very faster, and you can see it is super fast than the fingerprint scanner, but it is not very secure. And let's talk about the internals of this phone. And this phone comes with a Exynos 7904 processor with a 4GB RAM and 64GB internal storage, and multitasking is awesome on this phone. And the performance of this phone, I play S19 and I cannot notice any big lags. Some lags is here on default settings, and the phone is little bit warm in this area, but it is not very warm, and it is normal, not very warm, I have to say. And Exynos 7904 chipset, it is not is equal to the Snapdragon 660 processor. It is higher than the Snapdragon 660 and it is upper than the Snapdragon 632 processor in Honor 8C. But I have to say I cannot notice any lag in a UI. It is looking very faster. I opened all the application like Facebook, S49, Marvel Future Fights game. It is worked very okay. I cannot notice any big lag or crash on this phone. And let's talk about the camera on this phone. And the camera is a main highlight feature of this phone, and it is a 16+5 megapixel combination on the back, and it is a normal lens with a 16 megapixel lens with f1.7 aperture, and the secondary is a 5 megapixel ultra wide lens. And you can see I enable the ultra wide, and you can see notice the difference. It is huge difference. One thing I notice in the ultra wide lens and 5 megapixel, it is very bad quality compared to the 16 megapixel camera in a normal lens, and it is giving you a very good photos in daylight, but you can go in night side and it is very bad, I have to say, very bad, I have to say. But the normal lens is very okay, and it is a scene optimizer is here in this camera. It is enhances the picture with AI. The front camera is having a 16 megapixel. Let's quickly show you some feature of this phone, and you can see, and I have to say that the camera is very good on this phone, and live focus feature is here as well as a back as well as a front camera. And you can see I enable the, and you can see effect applied. I have to say the picture quality in daylight, it absolutely good, and the live focus feature is also here on the back, and back camera as well as the front camera is also record up to full HD, not 4K in this phone. And one thing I have more noticed in this phone, you can enable the ultra wide lens, and the flash is not giving you a on and off feature. You can go to normal and it is showing me the flash is on or off. That's a very bad thing, because you can go to night side and you can enable the ultra wide, it is not giving you the flash, is here in normal lens. And here there is some filters in the camera department, and the beauty mode is also here in this phone, but I off. And let's quickly show you the some camera samples of this phone as well as a you can better idea recording the camera performance of this phone. And let's talk about the battery life of this phone. And this phone comes with a 4000 mAh battery size with the support of fast charging. And this phone is giving you a same charger as the Samsung Galaxy S10 family. And this phone is giving you a 1.67 ampere with 9 volts, and it is a 15 watt fast charger. And it is not the fastest charger in the world, but it is giving you a faster charger as well as a USB Type-C port. And I cannot receive any security update, but this phone is giving you a 1.5 day battery life without any problem, 4000 mAh battery size, and this phone is charged about 2 hours and something minutes. And overall, I have to say I recommend to you phone, and this phone is very good in all condition. And one thing I have to say, that the speaker quality on this phone, you can adjust the sound level on high maximum, and it is little bit destroy, and you can down only one level and it is okay. That's a very about bad thing about this phone. And this phone is costing around 14,000 PKR, and I have to say it is very good phone. You can buy, I recommend to you guys, you can buy the A30, and it is a very good option for you. The battery life is good, the cameras as well as the display, battery life and fast charging. And this phone is awesome in this price range, and other companies is not giving you a ultra wide feature as well as a USB Type C port. And thank you so much for watching this full review of the Samsung Galaxy A30, and it is my 2 days experience with the A30. And let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. You want to see some more videos about the Oppo A3, and I catch you guys in the next one. Peace out.